Now, digestive issues like bloating, cramping and constipation, which are all symptoms of irritable bowel syndrome, are estimated to affect 1 in 5 people, and mostly women. Molkosan assists with supporting gut health and mild IBS digestive issues and has recently launched the 21-day Molkosan Challenge, which aims to help improve the participants' overall gut health. Now, this afternoon, we chat with local dietitian Catherine Day on the causes of these digestive issues and the importance of maintaining a healthy gut. Welcome to the show.
Thank you so much for having me today.
Oh, no, lovely. This is such an interesting topic because I think so many people suffer from it. So what exactly is IBS?
Well, IBS is a functional gut disorder that is characterized by changes in your bowel habits as well as abdominal pain.
Yeah.
And the causes of it, unfortunately, are not known. There are a lot of theories, and this makes it extremely frustrating for people with IBS because, you know, when they go to the doctor, they get no tests that come up as positive.
So there's no way of testing for it?
Not at the moment.
Okay.
So a couple of the theories behind the causes of IBS, they do suspect that there may be changes in inflammation within your gut lining, but unfortunately, these changes are so microscopic that a biomarker or a test hasn't actually been sort of invented yet.
Okay.
Other sort of theories behind the causes of IBS include differences in ways in which your gut bacteria are actually living in your gut. So they think that there's more unhealthy bacteria as opposed to healthy bacteria. And then also changes in the way your gut actually works. So we all have muscle contractions in our gut that helps move our food through. And in someone with IBS, there are actually changes within those muscular contractions.
Oh, wow. And then what would the symptoms be then of IBS?
So
like
symptoms,
a lot of pain, obviously.
Yes, include things like constipation, diarrhea, bloating, flatulence, and then obviously the abdominal pain as well. And then nausea and vomiting as well. Those are those two sort of big symptoms that people suffer from.
Every single time they eat?
Not every time they eat, so it's all about the management of IBS. There's no cure yet, and a lot of people have dietary triggers, so they may be okay with some food one day, and then the next day they'll bloat, and it will be so sort of deliberating that they'll kind of look like they're pregnant. That's a lot of what a lot of patients complain about.
Yeah, that bloating. But then what do you recommend then to fix it? Because I suppose if it is anything to do with inflammation or the fauna and flora, then I suppose something like Molkosan, because it's a probiotic?
So, yes, definitely. Probiotics have been found to be useful. But there's a lot of research behind this and, you know, they haven't quite gotten it down to what exact strain can help with IBS patients.
Yeah.
Because when it comes to gut bacteria, there are trillions and trillions of gut bacteria living in our gut. So researchers are also still trying to find what exact strain can best help you know, IBS patients deal with the symptoms, but it's all about management. So yes, definitely including probiotics into your way of eating or, you know, taking a supplement of sorts. And then mostly it's about looking at it holistically and kind of, you know, asking yourself, is your lifestyle conducive to no symptoms? Do you exercise? Do you manage your stress and anxiety? And then also looking at, you know, dietary triggers. So refined carbohydrates, wheat, we also look at fructose intake. There are a whole lot of things. So I think it's really quite, you know, something that we can still do something for. There's not no hope, if that makes sense. I think a lot of people just kind of take their IBS as something that they can't manage.
Yeah, you think you hear so many people just hearing that they've just got to live with it.
Definitely.
Where actually there are lots of little ways of getting around it. And just being conscious of what those triggers are, because then that could help you as well.
Yes, and I think that's the most frustrating thing, is that a lot of patients can't really figure out what their triggers are. And that's how dietitians can help patients, is to find out what their triggers are. And for the very sensitive tummies, there's actually something new called the low FODMAP diet, which can help a lot with sensitive tummies. So there is a lot of hope.
The low FODMAP.
FODMAP. So basically we look at the fermentable carbohydrates in a person's diet, because they ferment a lot, and when things ferment, they create gas, and that's what makes the bloating a lot worse.
Okay, so staying away from the kimchi and the sauerkraut then. So it certainly is amazing of how much of an impact our gut has on the rest of our body. Now, to stand a chance of winning a spa day for two and Molkosan products to the value of 3,000 Rand, simply start using Molkosan today, then head over to our social media pages and tell us what your digestive issues were and how Molkosan has helped you. So don't forget to use the hashtag Molkosan Challenge. Thank you so much for being here
today.
Thank
you very much for having me.
Mm-hmm.
Digestive problems are increasing. A. Vogel's Molkosan is a Swiss daily digestive tonic that's high in L+ lactic acid to support healthy gut.